So yes, did we all recover from that pretty cool post-launch content trailer announcement from Odyssey? Yeah, okay. Because I'm just getting started here with my Odyssey coverage, because we also learned about another big feature from Origins that will be returning, the fact that Odyssey is playable on the Nintendo Switch in Japan, that Eevee is in the game, and way more. So let's get into it. If you enjoyed that, then a like would be super appreciated, and let's go! Let's start with the Discovery Tour that will also make its return in Odyssey as noted by the official Ubisoft website. The line notes the return of guided tours, and of course the fact that you can explore the world that Ubisoft Quebec created without having to worry about enemies attacking you. When I visited Ubisoft Quebec, I got like a tour through Athens in the game from two developers that told me a lot about the history of that big city, and I was already like, this would be cool for a Discovery Tour for sure. There were some things that you could also like interact with as well, although I did not see that in action, but yeah, we saw that in the Origins Discovery Tour of course as well, so curious to see how fleshed out this Discovery Tour for Odyssey will be, but it's at least cool that we can experience this game in a different way. No words on when the Discovery Tour will be released, but likely during the first half of 2019, I would imagine. The one from Origins released in February 2018, so 4 months after the release. I know I haven't touched on this, although it was reported a while back by Games Radar, namely the fact that you can have Eevee on your ship. It will be a Ubisoft Club reward in the in-game store by going to the ship tab there. Like, not sure what the requirements will be to get those rewards, because I could not access the Ubisoft Club section during my demo. Maybe that you need to own Syndicate or something, because we do see that sometimes in other Ubisoft games, that the requirement to get the reward is that you need another game from Ubisoft. Like in Far Cry 5, you needed Primal in order to run around like a caveman. And what is interesting is that Eevee has been improved in terms of stats since the Gamescom demo, because when I looked at the shop during my recent play session, I saw she had a 9% javelin damage increase, 15% increase for the Vire javelin damage, and a legendary perk that increases your damage by 18% when you have low health. And to be clear, this of course for your ship, so not for your character on the ground, but for the naval combat. Because yes, by unlocking her, you get her on your ship and actually see her as well. And I know this makes zero sense because Eevee was far from born during the time of Odyssey, but let's be honest, it's pretty cool, even more so because this means that you can fight alongside her as well. I already showed you this high level stealth skill called Call to Arms in action in a recent video, where you summon one of your lieutenants to fight alongside you for a short period of time that can be extended once you upgrade the ability. So while I did not try it for myself, this on paper should mean that you can summon Eevee into the world and kill enemies alongside her. And I'm curious like what that will look like, but I mean, think of the possibilities. What if Ubisoft released every assassin as a lieutenant? Wouldn't that be super awesome? Okay, you cannot summon like two lieutenants at one time, but you could still see them all on your ship, four in total. But if you like board a ship, then all the lieutenants will join you on that other ship and fight alongside you there as well. So on paper, that would mean that if there would be more assassins, I mean, why would they only release Eevee? So if they release more assassins, that would mean that you could like fight alongside four assassins on one ship. I mean, hard to deny that that doesn't sound cool, right? So while I think that Eevee will likely be there at launch, since she was already in this build, I think the other assassins, if they will come, again, pure speculation, but why not? Then I think those will happen like later. But at launch, very likely, looking at the fact that they're already in the store, you can have your crew dress up as male or female assassins or even magis. So this is just a cosmetic thing that will not impact the power of your ship, but it will have an influence on the sound of the shanties you will hear while sailing the seas. Because you will hear men sing when you have crew members who are male, and you will hear female voices if you have women on your ship. It's a cool touch, and the voices should also differ for some of the crews that you can have on your ship. Not for every one of them, but some of them. And the songs will also change depending on the things you did in the game. So if you just did something cool in the main story, I would imagine, then you hear that on your ship when you sail to the next destination. So yes, different looking crew members and likely lieutenants will totally be available in the store and also as Ubisoft Club rewards. I could also take a look at the gear section of the store as well, but only saw some Ubisoft Club things that you can get, and some are rewards that you could only get during special events. Like the Dory was something that was tied to the E3 thing, where you had to ask the Ubisoft bot Sam about E3 rewards, and then you get that spear. But yeah, it's a blue spear, not really that good. The mount looks really cool though, with some sort of ponytail on the head there. I'm not sure if you can get that one, maybe by just spending the Ubisoft tokens from the Ubisoft Club section of the game, but when we know more, I will of course let you know. What we do know regarding the mounts is that the unicorn will be returning thanks to XS the Animus, who caught a GameStop pre-order for a black unicorn. I hope this will be available through other ways later on as well, because it does look really cool. At Origins, we of course had the white unicorn, like at launch. Maybe they will have that for Odyssey as well. It still kind of sucks that we only have like horses in this game, that we cannot get crazy stuff like the unicamel, because there's only so much you can do with horses. I will miss Gerta as well. Going back to the gear page, where we again see all those blue weapons, I would imagine that legendary items will be added at launch, just like we saw with Origins, where they already had a selection. We should expect the gear packs to return as well. Because if we look at the main menu of the store, you see upgrade your character with brand new team packs that include one gear set, so 5 armor pieces, 1 weapon, and also 1 mount. In Origins, this sometimes was different per gear pack, but it looks like it will be set here for Odyssey, so that every gear pack will include the same amount of items. We also see naval packs, so you can give your ship a unique style, so cosmetic things like crew members and ship designs are included. You can also buy more drachmae and resources, just like in Origins. So yes, seems pretty similar, only the ship things have been added. One of the highlights from the Odyssey Season Pass is of course that it includes the AC3 remaster. And now we learned that there's a pretty big team working on this. Ubisoft Barcelona namely tweeted this after the Season Pass announcement, and I count more than 40 people in this picture, so that again looks promising and will be needed for the things that Ubisoft is promising for this remaster. Like the improved gameplay mechanics and also the new graphics engine. Like, I'm curious to see the first footage of this to see the improvements. But I think we will have to wait till closer to the March 2019 release, where it will be released as a standalone download or again as part of the Odyssey Season Pass. Something totally different, but I still thought it was interesting to include it in this video. And that is namely the fact that in Japan you can play Assassin's Creed Odyssey on the Switch. So yes, the Switch is of course totally not able to run this game natively, so that's why Ubisoft is streaming it to the Nintendo hardware so people can still play it. Capcom already experimented with this with Resident Evil 7, and now Ubisoft is as well. I mean, it's still only for Japan right now, but now that Ubisoft, a Western company, is doing this, while Capcom is of course a Japanese company, I can totally see it come overseas as well. If that means that more people are playing Odyssey, then it's of course a win for Ubisoft. Not sure if Nintendo would allow it, because the streaming seems to be only a thing for Japan right now. And that is simply because the consoles over there are way less popular, so that's why it makes sense that Ubisoft wants to get it on the Switch. That is way more popular over there right now. But yeah, I would totally love to play Odyssey in my bed or on the toilet this way as well. Of course, you need a good internet connection, something I have. But it's still not for everyone. According to Nintendo World Report, the price is €64 or $75 for 2-year access to Odyssey via this streaming service. Or you can also pay a daily rate for $6.50 or €5.60. So yes, that is nice to try it out for one day, I guess. But the 2-year deal is of course way better. I mean, after 2 years, you are probably done with the game anyway, right? So then it's like buying the full version, of course. And those prices are, by the way, converted from the Japanese pricing, because it's of course not available over here. In Japan, this cloud version will be available on October 5th, so that is the same, of course, release date we have here, or October 2nd if you got the Gold Edition or up. Ubisoft Quebec just announced that the game has gone gold, so that means that they are printing the discs as we speak, making it ready for manufacturing. Although, obviously, they're still working like on day one patches, I would imagine, and a ton of other post-launch things they got coming to the game. TV spots for the game are also being prepared, so we will likely see them on TV around launch. Let's hope they still have a cinematic trailer in the pipelines, because that would really suck if we don't get one for Odyssey. We do know that there's a live-action trailer coming though, so we at least got that, I guess. But yeah, of course, subscribe for everything Assassin's Creed Odyssey as we near the release and beyond. Like this video to support the channel. Again, you can watch a full breakdown of the post-launch content trailer, including some cool things I learned by clicking on the screen. I also got my impressions up about the first 6 hours of the game, and we'll have more videos from that demo. I know I said that in previous videos as well, but because of the news that dropped recently, I wanted to discuss that first and then like go in depth on what I found in the demo. Some cool stuff. For now, I will just speak to you next time, and of course, goodbye.
Thank you.